रंजना यमुना तीरा वनचारी यमुना तीरा वनचारी जय राधा माधव कुंज विहार जय राधा माधव कुंज विहार हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे 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 कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे 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 कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे 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 कृष्णा 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 हरे राम 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 हरे हरे जय राधा गोपीनाथ राधा गोपीनाथ राधे जय प्रभुपदा जय प्रभुपदा जय प्रभुपाद जय प्रभुपाद जय जय गुरुदेव 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 जय गुरुदेव। ॐ नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय। ॐ नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय। ॐ नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय। नारायणं नमस्कृत्य नरं चैव नरोत्तमं देवीं सरस्वतीं व्यासं ततो जयमुदीरये। नष्टप्रायेषु भद्रेषु नित्यं भागवत सेवया भगवतीरुत्तमश्लोके भक्तिर्भवति नैष्ठिकी। Reading from Srimad Bhagavatam, 12th Canto, Chapter 1, entitled The Dynasties of Kali Yuga, text number 1 and 2. We'll read only one here. Sri Shuka Uvacha योऽन्त्यः पुरञ्जयो नाम भविष्यो बारहद्रथः तस्यामात्यस्तु शुनको हत्वा स्वामिनमात्मजम्। श्रीशुक उवाच योऽन्त्यः पुरञ्जयो नाम भविष्यो बारहद्रथः तस्यामात्यस्तु शुनको हत्वा स्वामिनमात्मजम्। श्रीशुक उवाच योऽन्त्यः पुरञ्जयो नाम भविष्यो बारहद्रथः तस्यामात्यस्तु शुनको हत्वा स्वामिनमात्मजम्। भारहद्रथः स्वामिनमात्मजम्। श्रीशुक उवाच योऽन्त्यः पुरञ्जयो नाम भविष्यो बारहद्रथः तस्यामात्यस्तु शुनको Hatva Swaminamatmajan. Sri Shuka Uvacha. Sri Shukadeva Goswami said, Yaha, who? Antyaha, the final member of the lineage described in the ninth canto. Puranjayaha, Puranjaya or Ripunjaya, Nama, named, Bhavishyaha, will live in the future. Bharahadratha, the descendant of Brihadratha. Tasya, his, Amatyaha, minister, to, but, Shunakaha, Shunaka, Hatva, killing, Swaminam, his master, Atmajam, his own son. Pradyota Sangyam Rajanam Karta Yatpalaka Sutaha Vishakha Yupastatputru Bhavita Rajakastataha. Translation. Shukadeva Goswami said, the last king mentioned in our previous enumeration of the future rulers of the Magadha dynasty were Puranjaya, who will take birth as a descendant of Brihadratha. Puranjaya's minister, Shunaka, will assassinate the king and install his own son, Pradyota, on the throne. The beginning of nepotism. The son of Pradyota will be Palaka. His son will be Vishakayupa and his son will be Rajaka. Purport by the disciples of Srila Prabhupada. The vicious political intrigue described here is symptomatic of the age of Kali. In the ninth canto of this work, Shukadeva Goswami describes how the great rulers of men descended from two royal dynasties, that of the sun and that of the moon. The ninth canto's description of Lord Ramachandra, a most famous incarnation of God, occurs in this genealogical narration. And at the end of the ninth canto, Shukadev describes the forefathers of Lord Krishna and Lord Balaram. Finally, the appearance of Lord Krishna and that of Balaram are mentioned within the context of the narration of the Moon Dynasty. The tenth canto is devoted exclusively to a description of Lord Krishna's childhood pastimes in Vrindavan, his teenage activities in Mathura and his adult activities in Dwarka. The famous epic Mahabharata also describes the events of this period, focusing upon the five Pandava brothers and their activities in relation with Lord Krishna and other leading historical figures such as Bhishma, Dhritarashtra, Dronacharya and Vidura. Within the Mahabharata is Bhagavad Gita, in which Lord Krishna is declared to be the absolute truth, the supreme personality of Godhead. Srimad Bhagavatam, of which we are presently translating the 12th and final canto, is considered a more advanced literature than the Mahabharata, because throughout the entire work, Lord Sri Krishna, the absolute truth and supreme source of all existence, is directly centrally and irrefutably revealed. In fact, the first canto of the Bhagavatam describes how Sri Vyasadeva composed this great work because he was dissatisfied with his rather sporadic glorification of Lord Krishna in the Mahabharata. Although Srimad Bhagavatam narrates the histories of many royal dynasties and the lives of innumerable kings, not until the description of the present age, the age of Kali, do we find a minister assassinating his own king and installing his son on the throne. This incident resembles Dhritarashtra's attempt to assassinate the Pandavas and crown his son Duryodhan king. As the Mahabharata describes, Lord Krishna thwarted his attempt, but with the departure of Lord for the spiritual sky, the age of Kali became fully manifested, ushering in political assassination within one's own house as a standard technique. Om Ajnana Timirandhasya Jnananjana Shalakaya Chakshurunmilitam Yena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Shri Chaitanya Mano Bhishtam Sthapitam Yena Bhutale Swayam Rupa Kadamahyam Dadati Swapadantikam Vandeham Shri Guru Shri Yuta Padakamalam Shri Gurun Vaishnavamscha Shri Rupam Sagrajatam Sahagana Raghunathanvitam Tam Sajivam Sadvaitam Savadhutam Parijana Sahitam Krishna Chaitanya Devam Shri Radha Krishna Padan Sahagana Lalita Shri Vishakanvitamscha He Krishna Karuna Sindhu Dina Bandhu Jagatpate Gopesha Gopika Kanta Radha Kanta Namostute Tapta Kanchana Gaurangi Radhe Vrindavaneshwari Vrishabhanu Sute Devi Pranamami Hari Priye Vancha Kalpatarubhyascha Kripa Sindhubhya Evacha Paditanam Pavanibhyo Vaishnavibhyo Namo Namaha Jaya Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shri Vasadi Gaura Bhakta Vrinda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare 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 Krishna. At the outset, I would like to offer my respectful obeisances at the feet of His Holiness Srila Bhaktichara Swami Maharaj, who departed from amongst us yesterday. Putting practically the whole ISKCON society to a state of grief and a heartbreak situation. Personally, I had the good fortune of interacting with him whenever I would go with a group of devotees for a yatra to Ujjain. And whenever Maharaj was there, personally, he would make it a point to address us, took out time, and as in his so characteristic of him, such a refined gentleman, such a sweet Vaishnav, with such refined personification of Vaishnav etiquette, would take pleasure in glorifying His Holiness Radhanath Swami Maharaj and so many other devotees. Just in His presence, everyone would be so much inspired and also take time to answer any questions simple young devotees that had. And we all know how many times He came here, and whenever He came here, we would invariably request Him to sing the Gopi Geet. and that verse that Lord Chaitanya glorified when it came out from the mouth of Maharaj Prataprudra, Tava Kathamritam Tapta Jeevanam. Truly, He was such a Bhurida, traveling all over the world, filling devotees' ears and hearts with that sweet, melodious and loving Krishna Kathamritam. You know, in the burning hearts of the conditioned souls. So truly it is a big loss to the ISKCON world. Somebody who served Srila Prabhupada so closely, so intimately, especially in his final days, and whom Prabhupada trusted so much to have given him the status of being a sannyasi very quickly, in quick succession. So, it is really, especially to his own disciples, because 15 days back he was, you know, speaking about traveling and preaching, and 15 days later is no more there. So it is really, must be a real shock. We can all very much understand. So, as His Holiness Radhanath Swami yesterday, speaking to His disciples, made it a very interesting point that, yes, inevitably this may happen that, you know, we physically we may not be able to associate anymore, but to the extent we are fully absorbed in what He stood for, His instructions, His whole example of His own life, then you will feel, like Prabhupada said, I never was a time that I felt separation from my spiritual master. They can't be compared. Physical presence has its own taste and flavor that cannot be compared with. But then, Lord Chaitanya's philosophy comes to our rescue, at least in that sense, that it can still be very much, or rather, in fact, much more in alignment, in tune, and in presence, feeling the presence of great souls when we understand their instructions and follow. Hare Krishna. Today we are also entering the 12th canto. I think this is the first time, because when I joined in 89, I was discussing with Govinda Prabhu. We had first canto only. Only two copies were available. So we did that, and then was second canto was not available. So they started third canto. And then they started seventh canto. That is the time I came, because I remember around the time I came, 89 December, there was one devotee, Shuchi Prabhu, he gave a class. And that class was how Hiranyakashipu, Lord Narasimhadev was playing with Hiranyakashipu as a cat plays with a rat or Garuda plays with a snake. I very distinctly remember that class. He had very graphically mentioned that. So around 7th canto we started at that time. And it ended 10th canto, 14th chapter. 10.13. It ended in 1995. Around 95, December. And then it was decided that we'll start from first canto. Because by the time full Bhagavatam, everything was there, so Prabhupada's own words, so we'll start from first canto. So around 95 end or 96 beginning, maybe if you see the media, exactly when that first canto started. And from 96 it is now, we come to the 12th canto. In this very lifetime we will finish this canto. So we are entering the 12th canto now, and in the last few weeks there has been elaborate and very deep and variegated perspectives that has been presented by various devotees having different flavors to this already sweet narration of Shukadeva Goswami's sweet nectarian pastimes of Krishna. But especially this was like the departure of Krishna. Not very pleasant to the devotees, because at least with regard to Krishna, they don't like to discuss this pastime. Not very sweet. It's about associating and meeting. However, various devotees presented so many acharyas' perspectives on how to understand this. I would like to share with you what Krishna speaks about his disappearance pastime. If Krishna were to come and we were to ask him, Prabhu, give a Bhagavatam class and you tell about your disappearance pastime. Why did you do it? How do we understand it? Wouldn't it be exciting to hear from Krishna himself? And that's what it is. 500 years ago, Krishna came as Lord Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And he, in his instructions to Sri Srila Sanatana Goswami, whose disappearance date is today, Guru Purnima. So, the biggest Govardhan Parikrama happens today. All Brajavasis consider him as their inspirational and surrendered guru. So, while instructing Sanatana Goswami, Lord Chaitanya specifically made this statement about certain pastimes you should be very careful about while hearing. I would like to read that verse. In Chaitanya Charitamrita, this is Madhyalila, 23rd chapter, 117 and 118, two verses. Maushala Lila Ara Krishna Antardhan Keshavatara Arajata Virudha Vyakhyan Mahishi Harana Adi Sab Mayamay Vyakhya Shikhaila Jaiche Susiddhanta Hai. Illusory stories opposed to the conclusion of Krishna consciousness concern the destruction of the Yadu dynasty, Krishna's disappearance, the story that Krishna and Balaram arise from a black and a white hair of Kshirodakshaya Vishnu, and the story about the kidnapping of the queens. Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu explained to Sanatana Goswami the proper conclusions of these stories. So four pastimes are very bewildering, especially with regard to Krishna Leela. Maushal Leela, Mushala, that came out from Samba's womb, and therefore the whole pastime is called Maushal Leela, the disappearance of the Yadu dynasty. You know, so many various lessons. Krishna, whatever he does, he teaches so many lessons. Especially for Kali Yuga, how offenses could be so dangerous to destroy not just you but the whole dynasty. Or Krishna Antardhan, the way Krishna disappeared. Keshavatara, this is the, in Mahabharata, this particular verse comes, which is quoted in this purport to this verse, where it is described that Kshirodakshai Vishnu pulled out two hairs from his head. One grey hair, white hair, and a black hair. How does Krishna have grey hair? He is Navanavayamanam, Navayavanam. But if he wants, he can. So he pulled out two hair, white hair and a black hair. And from the white hair came Balramji, and from the black hair came Krishna. So this is Keshavatar. And this is very prevalent in many places. There, speak this, you know, as the ultimate truth. Arayata viruddha vyakhyan mahishi harana. The way while Arjuna was taking all these queens, if we especially read it in the Mahabharata, it's extremely horrifying. It really churns your heart. How can this happen to Krishna's wife? Impossible. Either it didn't happen or Krishna is not God. How could he allow this to happen? Like Prem Kishore Prabhu was mentioning, "Are ya, bibi mere hirde mein baithta nahi." Dukh ho raha hai. Very difficult to. So, Mahishi Harana Adi Sabha Maya Maya Vyakhya Shikhaila Jaiche Susiddhanta Hoy. But specifically Krishna did this to begin Kali Yuga. Otherwise Kali Yuga could not begin so quickly after the Supreme Personality of Godhead's departure. Because he had destroyed all the, you know, Vinashaya Sadushkritam, he had done it fully, successfully. And Paritranaya Sadhunam. It was too much like a Satyuga atmosphere. Where would Kali Yuga come? So substantial foundation had to be given. And that could only happen if the ultimate spirit is considered fully mundane. Avajananti mam mudhaha manushim tanu ashritam param bhavam ajananto mabhuta maheshwar. Avajananti mam mudhaha. Unless they deride, how would Kali Yuga begin? Recently somebody sent me a question. Somebody had sent about this Brahma Padartha, Jagannath ji, into which there is, and then it says that, some electromagnetic thing coming in, and it came from Krishna's remains. Somebody picked it up and then brought, and hey, somebody pass the mic. Please. What exactly is that Can you please throw some light?
No, I can just say what is in the video. He's saying, actually I wanted to put that on our forum, you know, how Krishna's deluding energy works, it's still working. People are still coming out with such theories, they say that that actually Krishna's heart is something which gets activated, starts vibrating when it is exposed to light. So when Jara went, he said he saw just the heart was remaining, everything else was destroyed. When Jara cremated the Lord's body and everything got destroyed except the heart. Heart was still there, so he carried that heart and he went all over the world. Nobody wanted to keep it, and then finally he came to the king of Orissa, and the king of Orissa, he kept it. But then, you know, that's the reason why they say also that it is electromagnetically active, so therefore they keep the deities of, that's the theory, deities of Jagannath, Baldev, Subhadra are wood, because it is electromagnetically inert. So many, you know, they try to fit the facts, you know, to fit the facts to their version, to conform to their version. It was so amazing. I was laughing throughout.
And all my connections, my previous connections to Krishna consciousness, anything that comes about Krishna and confusing, they send it to me. Yeah, they say, aisa kaisa? Yeah, they say, dekho tumhara Krishna. Very rare to send, are kya Krishna hai aapke? So, this is just a sample. So subtly it is clear cut that Krishna was there, it was burned and some remains were there. From there came this. And this is the soul. And if the soul is not there, then the body of Jagannath ji is not activated. It is not said, but that's what it leads to. And Swarup Damodar Goswami, when a poet made this during Lord Chaitanya's time, composed this, and Bhagwan Pandit encouraged him, I said, hey, bahut acha hai, thoda Mahaprabhu ko sunao ye presentation, where he said that Jagannath is the body and Chaitanya, Lord Chaitanya is the soul. And right there, Swarup Damodar Goswami caught him and started explaining, and the person was very much embarrassed and very much repentant, and he actually surrendered. He became a resident of Jagannath Puri and became an associate of the Lord. But then Swarup Damodar explained how Saraswati has used this for glorification, how the same Lord is now moving around amongst all of us. Like that. But the point is, essentially, any of these pastimes which make Krishna look to be anything below his original position, anything below that original position, is sarva maya may and viruddha vyakhyan, aryata viruddha vyakhyan. It is opposed to the true conclusion of the Vedic literature. So there is a book written, I think, in the early 1920s, 1930s by one Raghav Chaitanya by name, Divine Name. Beautiful book. One of the very, very sweet books that I came across in terms of Haridas Thakur's life and teachings, and based on that, the glory of the holy name. Beautifully compiled. And so he mentions that how so many people have so many different conceptions about Krishna here in India, the land of his appearance, the birth of the Vedic culture. And he gives different levels of understanding of people. And these are all scholars. As Prabhupada explains in that purport, I think 7.15, Namam Duskritano Mudha Naradhama Maya Apartha Jnana Asuram Bhavama. philosophers, administrators, and various leaders of society in various fields, they give solutions to this problem of the world without understanding the essential solution. Mameva ye prapadyante mayametam tarantit. It's so simple, but it's not understood by these people, because somewhere the foundational principle is wrong. So the first level of people are, and they are fully convinced about this, is Krishna doesn't exist. They deny his existence. He didn't exist. There was no one like Krishna. It is an allegory that was creation of a poet's mind. That is one understanding. And they give so many justifications for it. Very convincing, because they are erudite scholars, glib talkers. Another people say, arrogance of their own purity, so-called purity. They say he was an immoral person. He's a voluptuous, very, very kamuk, lampat. That was Krishna. It's a little painful to even speak from Vyasasana like that on Guru Purnima day, Vyas Purnima day, sitting on the Vyasasana. But that's what it is. That is a fact. Navam duskritam mudha prapadyante. So that is another. Next, they take some people who are Hindutva kind of brand, want to at the same time in a compromising way or in a kind of trying to protect the culture, etc. Say, arre, no, he was a powerful warrior, very astute statesman, very able administrator, very agile and very thoughtful politician. And a ruler of the Yadava dynasty. And he was able to keep the evil power at that time under full control. So at least they ascribe historicity to him, the historical personality. Some people mercifully promote him to a social reformer. He was a social reformer. He understood the burning social issues of the time. He gave shelter to 16,000 queens who were rejected by then those social customs. He gave them that status, a big social reformer. The way he dealt with all classes of people. Some elevate him to a great philosopher. A great philosopher of that time. And he gave a philosophy which is even now invigorating to the spiritual spiritual life of people. His Gita. Very profound philosopher. And prophet of his times. And then there are the impersonalists who say, no. He is not just an ordinary. No, this. He is nothing but that nirgun, nirakar, nirvishesh, sarvavyapi Brahma who has taken a body made of sattva-guna to actually appear amongst us and to establish his principles. But even that is straight away slapped in Bhagavad Gita itself. 7.24, if I am right. Avyaktam vyaktimapannam manyante mam abuddhaya param bhavam janantu mamavyayam anuttamam. Naham prakasha sarvasya yogamaya samavrata. Moodhoyam. Some people say, no. Like Keshavatar, he is one of the innumerable incarnations of Lord Vishnu. Some even say, go further and say, no. He is a complete and perfect Purna avatar of Vishnu. All others are manifesting a little bit power, but he is a Purna avatar. But only Srimad Bhagavatam, compiled by Vyasadeva, the original compiler of the Vedas, he in the peak of his ultimate summum bonum, presents Krishna as he is the supreme absolute truth, satyam param dhimahi. Ete cha amshakala pumsa krishnastu bhagavan swayam indrari vyakulam lokam radayanti yuge yuge. Many years ago, I was at Kolhapur for Janmashtami. I had prepared a 7 days talk on Krishna from Mahabharata. And every 2 days was different. Krishna as a peacemaker, Krishna as an avatar, Krishna as this, Krishna as that, like that. Different aspects of Krishna from the Mahabharata. And the day I was to begin, His Holiness Bhakti Rasamrita Maharaj had come to Kolhapur. And he was on his way to Belgaum. But he happened to come to the temple and I was about to begin the lecture. So I told him, Maharaj, why don't you speak a few words? And he made an interesting point. He just spoke for about 5-10 minutes. But who he is, highly, learned and scholarly, good debater also, started this national debate competition in 1996, Prabhupada's centennial time, national debate competition. Sitting here, I was wondering how would you manage it, somehow managed. So, he sat there and he said, if you want to read Mahabharata, you have to wear two spectacles. Two sets of spectacles. Because one set means two, not two spectacles means two glasses. He said, two sets of spectacles you have to wear. Only then you can appreciate Mahabharata. Otherwise, and he quoted this particular verse from the Chaitanya Charitamrita. And he said, what are these two spectacles? The first spectacles is Srimad Bhagavatam. And the second spectacle is Chaitanya Charitamrita. After you wear these two spectacles, when you read Mahabharata, you will be in ecstasy when you see, wow, Krishna, what he does. Otherwise, why does Krishna do this? Who is Krishna, by the way? Actually, one of the reasons, Vyasadeva says at the very outset, one of the 7 or 8 reasons is Vasudevasya Mahatmyam. One reason I am glorifying, writing Mahabharata, Vasudevasya Mahatmyam, in so many places. Bhishma, in fact, glorifies all the Dashavatars during the Rajasuya sacrifice. So many places, clearly it is indicated, who is this personality? But it's amazing how after reading all that, still people get confused. That is why he was dissatisfied, and Narada could actually immediately identify the root cause. So, you need to work on that, and as it is mentioned here very beautifully in this purport, Within the Mahabharata is Bhagavad Gita, in which Lord Krishna is declared to be the absolute truth, the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Srimad Bhagavatam, so than the Mahabharata, because throughout the entire work, Lord Sri Krishna, the absolute truth and the supreme source of all existence, is directly, centrally and irrefutably revealed, which has not happened in the Mahabharata. But it's amazing that the Lord did all this and still left enough doubt for him to be considered an ordinary person. I mean, imagine lifting Govardhan in the left finger and still saying, and still people have confusion. Only Krishna can do this. Or his illusory energy can actually leave solid evidence for everyone to think their own way of who is Krishna. So, of course, Kali Yuga had to begin. It started when Krishna himself was there, practically, you know, a little bit, but it couldn't have full impact. But as soon as Krishna left, you know, it became manifest. I was in Moscow, and in the Brahmachari Ashram, just across the street, it's in a, away from the city, very green, nice place. So, across the street, I mean, there's a main road, and across the main road, there is one, this bar and restaurant type. And there's a bright light, that name, you know, it's written in Russian, so you can't understand. The huge light. It's a red color board with bluish written, and it's so bright. And it was on the whole day. Big board, fully backlit board, like a neon sign. Fully, but throughout the day it was just not visible at all. But as soon as the sun would set, this would become prominent. And when the sun fully set, you could see nothing in the horizon except this light. This was practically the sun, the only luminous object in the sky. So when the sun sets, even glowworms become prominent. So this is what happened, that during Krishna's time, it's just kind of, as it is explained here, the kings, you know, hooking in some kind of a conspiracy to throw, like a coup, which happens every, you know, month in Africa. One person takes over the whole king, become the king of that particular place, and he goes for an outing with his wife. By the time he comes, already somebody else is occupied. As I said, this is lockdown, you can go back to wherever you have come from. So, and they would take up their, you know, communication headquarters, the TV and the radio center, and announce, this is the current update. Today this fellow is the king, this is the rule. It's so common now. Anyone can throw out anyway, especially during the Mughal time, you see. Little bit here and there, and it's overthrown in somebody else. And that flow is overthrown by somebody else, and somebody else comes. Where is that, and where is the kind of kings we used to have before, who really won the heart of the masses as their father figure? That they couldn't feel, you know, a life could exist. Just like it's described when Lord Ram was leaving, or when Krishna left Vrindavan, whatever. This feelings were like a soul going away from the body. Interestingly, 5,000 years ago when Kali had started its manifesting his power, the first thing that Parikshit saw was a low-class man dressed as the chief administrator, doing the very thing, destroying or hurting the very thing he's supposed to protect. A cow and a bull. This is also very interesting. They're supposed to protect. Go Brahmana Hitayacha. And here he is, Naradeva. Naradeva means representative of the Lord on earth, on behalf of the Lord. The scepter that the king held and the crown represented that. Just like Vyasasan means this belong, anyone who sits has a great responsibility to speak in alignment with the person who gave the original essence of the truth. Similarly, the king meant he is a representative of the Lord on earth. And here was this low-class person dressed as a king and breaking the feet of Dharma. And I think Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur explains in one place that this is a vision in the yogic trance Parikshit Maharaj saw. While at one level it was also happening, but this is, he saw the state of this earth. Kings would be like this. Uncultured, unqualified, untrained people who will occupy these positions of protection and destroy the very thing that they are supposed to be protecting. And that is Kali Yuga. His Grace Burijan Prabhu, in his book, Unveiling His Lotus Feet, when he begins this, he writes it in terms of conversations. So beautifully compiling the different purports of the various acharyas and Srila Prabhupada's, predominantly Srila Prabhupada's perspectives from those purports. The flow, smooth flow of the Bhagavatam. And there, reward and punishment of Kali, 17th chapter, when he begins, he, in few, 2-3 paragraphs, explains what is Kali Yuga. The essence of Kali Yuga. It was really, when I first read it, I was very, very appealing to my heart. He said, Kali means only one thing. Minimizing authority. To bring irreligiosity. Who is the supreme authority? Ekale Ishwar Krishna Arsab Bhritya. Jare jaiche nachaye se taiche kare nritya. All hierarchy of leadership essentially comes from the Supreme Lord. If there is doubt even in his existence or in his supremacy, then easily irreligion can be practiced. So Kali strikes at the very root of the highest authority. And that is existence of God. Acha, if you remove God, whom do you put in his place? Ishwaroham aham bhogi siddhoham balavan sukhi. So atheism, beginning by the highest of sense enjoyment. And the last snare of Maya is you are God, even spiritually speaking, in terms of I am that. A spiritual suicide, finishing off one's existence. Then it becomes very easy. So there is a whole hierarchy. In Vedic culture, there are maintainers and the maintained. The supreme maintainer, eko bahu naam yo vidadhati kaman. The supreme maintainer is Krishna. And anyone who takes the position of maintainer, be it the king, be it a demigod, be it the parents, be it the husband, be it a guru, guru na sasyat, sajano na sasyat, pita na sasyat, jani na sasyat, daivam na sasyat, patim na sasyat, namo chaye tat samupeta mrityum. The purpose of anyone who takes the role of a leadership position, of a maintainer, is to care the maintained in such a way to create a atmosphere, a situation whereby they can flourish, and by nourishing them in such a way that they can achieve the perfection of life, which is namo chaye tat samupeta mrityu. And when will that happen? Janma karma chame divyam evam yoveti tattvata. When they convincingly understand that Krishna is the Supreme Personality of Godhead, He is the only truth, and anyone who represents genuinely, one can take shelter. So in this society, there are four types of relationship from maintainer and maintained, broadly he says. One is the parents and the children, the husband and the wife, the guru and disciples, or the priest and the congregation, and then there is the administrative head, the king, and the subjects. These are the maintainers from an individual to a social level. What does Kali do? Kali shows the leaders as inept and corrupted. That's it. As soon as you see the maintainer as inept, unqualified, or corrupt, or exploitative, then naturally you rebel. He's not doing a right job. He's not doing his responsibility. I can easily do that. I can do better than that. That's exactly how Kali started. This, as Prabhupada mentions, the puffed up Brahmana boy, immature, puffed up Brahmana boy, and undeniable justification. You can't deny it. It shows clearly. See, like Mantra showing to Kaikeyi, clear cut evidence. Maharaj Dasharatha didn't tell you. He didn't send invitation to these people. And then it gives, weaves a whole story behind it. So clear cut fault. Parikshit Maharaj, here is, how could he put a snake around this? Therefore I curse. So, or when the maintainer or the leader is questioned, naturally, everyone wants to break the chain of the subordination. Subordination is the last thing that people want in this world, especially in Kali Yuga. Why should I be subordinate? Free for all, freedom, independence. That's the name of the game, as they say. I want to be independent, I want to be free. And fully justified. Because look at the leaders. Look at the newspaper, the kind of spiritual, so-called spiritual people, and all scams being exposed. Leaders scamming crores of rupees and millions of crores of rupees. Now that has become just, you know, like, kitna karod, kitna hajar karod, kitna hajar karod. How do we expect people to have trust, complete, like a child sleeping on the mother's lap, completely trusting? And then the pet theory of Kali Yuga is theory of evolution. It was not Darwin. It was Kali speaking through Darwin. The theory of evolution means completely opposite of culture. That means it is not, you know, like we say, Satyuga, Treta Yuga, Dwapara Yuga. It is devolving. बोले नहीं, इवॉल्विंग मैन थ्रू टेक्नोलॉजी एंड साइंस इज इवॉल्विंग. सो देयरफॉर एज सून एज वी से एवोल्यूशन, दैट मीन्स एनीथिंग एंशिएंट, एनीथिंग ओल्ड इज नो मोर यूजफुल. ऑल दिस ट्रेडिशनल स्टफ छोड़ो यार, इट्स इरेलेवेंट. Something may be irrelevant, some rituals may be irrelevant, but the essence also, along throwing a baby out of the bath water. So everything we keep aside, we discover our own, we invent our own. As soon as a person becomes independent of proper authorities, this is the explanation he gives. So women fighting for that independence from, you know, too much of, you know, subordination, they become independent. Children walk away from home. People walk away spiritually from their leaders. Everyone creates their own. And the, why should the citizen pay taxes at all? Try to evade tax. Why should I pay? Because that fellow is exploiting, is eating. So as soon as the nature of the soul is to be dependent and happy, satisfied, blissful, peaceful. When under a powerful leader, everyone is happy. But the leader also thinks himself to be a servant. Krishna himself becomes a servant. Bhakta paradhino. Such a sweet Vaikuntha atmosphere. From there it turns into, everyone walks away and wants to become independent, which is not the nature, which is against the grain of the nature of the soul. And when that happens, he says, Burijan Prabhu says, three things happen. Number one, anxiety, because you have to fend for yourself. Number two, dissatisfaction, because the nature of the soul is to be subordinate. Mamai vamsho jiva loke. To be subordinate and to be completely, you know, serving. That's the nature. Jivar swarup hoy. Krishna Nitya Das or Dasanu Das. The whole nature. And therefore a person is dissatisfied. He's not in his natural, original nature, trying to be the controller, proprietor, the enjoyer. Maybe mind may be happy, but the soul is not. And third thing is, there is anxiety, there is dissatisfaction, loneliness. Loneliness. And I was thinking, to fulfill these things, to fulfill the anxiety, to overcome the anxiety, you need intoxication. Because it's too much anxious situation. Everyone knows cigarette smoking injurious to health. Everyone knows these things. But then that's what keeps them from that anxiety. And secondly, for dissatisfaction, illicit relationships. We want a relationship without responsibility. And therefore, this is very prominent to fulfill that dissatisfaction. And for the loneliness, virtual kind of world. You don't want real world. It's too scary. It's too harsh. It's too disappointing. It's too frustrating. Because, and what does Kali do? Kali does only one thing. Kali puffs up the false ego of the living entity. And he quotes Prabhupada in the third canto. He says, the ultimate expression of false ego is godlessness. Ishwaro aham, aham bhogi. Or in Mayavadi sense, aham brahmasmi. So, when the ego is so prominent, the ego's hunger is to amass, but the soul's nature is totally opposite to the ego's. And therefore they are inside, externally successful, internally miserable. No wonder there is a suicide. The ego wants more and more and more. The soul can't handle it. It's against its grain. That's not its nature. We want the whole world to serve, but unless we serve, we can't be happy. And therefore, in this situation, when I was reading this, I said, and for Kali Yuga, the Yuga avatar is Lord Chaitanya. And he has come with a formula to deal with the root. The Kali means to puff up the ego, and the Yuga avatar does one thing, and that is remove the false ego. Gopi Bhartur Padakamali or Das, 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 Anudas. It's like hammering the ego. It's too painful. Not digestible at all to the ego. Tad bhritya bhritya paricharaka bhritya 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 se bhritya arara. It's like too much for the ego. Trunada pisuni chena, taroriva saishuna, amanina manadena. All these four are anti-ego. Trunada pisuni chena. How can you be humbler than a blade of grass? Everyone trampling over you and no responding. Thorori was used to not tolerate, giving respect to everyone, expecting none in return. Unimaginable. But Lord Chaitanya has given a process by which it can be easily done. And that, therefore, Lord Chaitanya is the Yuga avatar. He should be worshipped on this day. During Lord Chaitanya's time also, Vyas Puja, you know, when Vyas Guru Purnima came, Vyas Purnima. So Srivas Thakur arranged for everything and he handed the garland to Nityananda and he said, offer it to Vyasdev. So be it. So be it. Are you offer it to Vyasdev? But he won't do it. So Srivas Thakur complained to Lord Chaitanya. Bolo isko, aapka hi sunta hai bas. Kisi unke sunta hi nahi hai. Nitai, offer it to Vyasdev. Okay, he offered it to him. Because his presentation of that Vedic knowledge that Vyasdev has presented is what works in this day and age. True representative of Vyas is the source of Vyas. Vyasaya Vishnu Rupaya Vyasa Rupaya Vishnave Namo Vai Brahma Nidhaye Vasisthaya Namo Nama. So, literary incarnation of the Lord, and here the Supreme Lord Himself coming and demonstrating how to actually do that. And by taking up the process, it's interesting, within the desert-like situation of Kali Yuga, an oasis of true essence of Vedic culture in the form of creating a Vaikuntha atmosphere, the potential is there if only we simply follow the process recommended by Lord Chaitanya. And how Srila Prabhupada actually inculcated it or instituted it. In the Western world, where the phrase that was popular at that time, slogan, don't trust anyone above 30, that was the mood of rebellion. Just be for yourself, fend for yourself, just be, you know, like. From there, to give them that faith, it's such a big responsibility. And it's truly amazing how an old man of 70, walking right into the den of Kali, right into the den of Kali, and proving that it still works. people, unless they see, actually in Kali Yuga, even this philosophy doesn't make sense. Until people need to have pratyaksha praman. They give more emphasis to that. There is one person who speaks, you know, like organic. You speak, the whole world you tell. It is so convincing intellectually, philosophically, logically, scientifically, highly convincing on to the intelligence. No one practices it. Until and unless you show them a patch of land, few acres, where you have actually grown something and you show them, I haven't put any chemicals and things have happened. One of our devotees from Nasik was telling, he grows acres and acres of grapes. He himself says, Prabhuji, hum log thoda sa hum log chadate hain, wo hamare liye rakhte hain. Aur sab to bina chemical ke nahi hota ho. Hum log thoda kam wala rakhke kuch khate hain bas. Aur wo bhi, it's impossible. He said, wo sab bhai, but you show me. Then he was taken to one particular place and that person showed just a patch of land where he had done it without any chemicals being used. When he saw that, he was convinced to try on half acre of land in his hundreds of acres. He's convinced to try a little bit, let me see. And if it works, then I will try to gradually expand. Otherwise, he can also give seminars. But he was not convinced that it works. Show me actually a patch. So even though sometimes we feel Krishna conscious philosophy is so simple, why can't people accept it? Even if it galat hai pan galat nahi. Sometimes people can appreciate it intellectually, but he says not possible. It is not possible. When they come in an atmosphere where there is a tinge of that at least seen, experienced, then they may develop a little faith. Maybe. Ho sakta hai. Probably we could try. Then probably philosophy will make sense as to why things are happening the way it is happening. So it is a fact. Even Krishna has said, yad yad acharati. And Srila Prabhupada showed it, not here, but in the den at that time of Kali. It's like Prahlad going into the right under the nose of Hiranyakashipu, preaching to the demons right in his household, in his kingdom. So similarly, Srila Prabhupada going and exhibiting the proof of how this is practical. Of course, practical by the power, by the mercy of Krishna, Lord Chaitanya. So, actually this is the day we worship Vyasadeva. Guru Purnima, sometimes the impersonalists, all gurus put in one place only and they don't worship their personal individual gurus. But in a Vaishnava philosophy, Guru Purnima is the day we worship Vyasa, who actually gave the knowledge, literary incarnation, who actually presented this. And we also worship the individual representatives on their appearance days who are keeping the tradition of Vyas alive. That's the understanding. But we also, as Lord Chaitanya did, and his followers did, we worship Vyas they want today. And how fortunate we are that a personality like Srila Prabhupada has brought Vyas alive in our life, truly, truly. Otherwise, so many people read. I know so many people, my relatives, my friends, my associate whom I know, they all read. They know Vyas Dev, they know Bhagavatam, they know everything. It's like lost in the forest. They don't know where is what is the conclusion. One day they are reading this, one day they are reading this, one day they are following that, one day they are worshipping this. They just lost whatever inspires them on the spur of the moment. But it's Lord Chaitanya who brought it alive and relevant for the Kali Yuga in a way that can be very, very easily practiced. And so this 12th canto will speak that even in the future, it will speak that in this there is only one hope. Nama Sankirtanam Yasya Sarva Papa Pranashanam Pranamo Dukkha Shamanastam Namami Harimparam. This is the reality. And if that reality is held on to, then irrespective of the surrounding atmosphere being completely going opposite, still there is hope for survival and perfection. Thank you very much. Today being Sunday, spoke a little extra. Any question? 5 minutes we have. Sunday means 9:30. Yes, Vishwambar Prabhu, Sri Vishwambar.
Prabhuji, you said that point on how in the age of Kali, the age of Kali strikes us by seeing fault in the authority. Now, like we can see faults everywhere and we can see fault in authority. So, how can we, you know, how can we work against this tendency in us, seeing fault in authority so prominent in everyone?
By becoming a saragrahi. First of all, understand the sara. Yesterday, Gopinath, Gopinath Chandra Prabhu presented sara. You know, he selected like a jewels from 11th canto and presented sambandha abhideya prayojan. He did make a point. I like that particular point. He said, when we say devotional service is easy, it's a sambandha. From our side, it's difficult. From his side, it's always open. Lord's side, it's always open. So sambandha is very easy. The day you say, Krishna, I'm yours, ho gaya sambandha. Jud gaya phir se. And when devotional service is difficult, it is abhideya. So, first of all, understand the essence. So when you understand the essence, even in authorities, if there is that essence that you take, that much you take, rest, you neglect, knowing that this is Kali Yuga. In Kali Yuga, it is ocean of faults. Kalau dosha nidhi rajan, asti eko mahan guna. If we become saragrahi, mature enough to neglect everything else, if that essence is there, little bit, whatever little, I take only that part. I just neglect the rest. That is between them and Krishna. That Krishna let him do. I see only this. Number one, niraparadhe namaloile paye premadhan. That's the only thing that obstacle, and that's the simplest, stupidest, easiest things to do is to find fault. And there are, you know, without telling anything, you can get pages and pages. Tons of faults in anyone. Why? Because kalau dosha nidhe raja. But if he becomes saragrahi, wherever we see, we take only that. If that much is there, we take. Rest. We just do the needful. We just do the needful. And we try to cultivate within us as much as that sara. I think in 1993, His Holiness Satsarup Goswami Maharaj wrote an article. It immediately struck me as, wow, you know, lessons from road. There was an article that used to come in the Bhagavatam and in the Back to Godhead magazine. And that article, the title was Idealism, Realism and Maturity. This was the title. So idealism, he explains that when we first came into Krishna consciousness, we thought everyone is a pure devotee and we will do like this Harinam and you know, and we will go on forever. You know, we can conquer the whole world and things like that. So that was idealism. And then he says, after Srila Prabhupada left, so many things started, everything started collapsing. This was the reality. Then, he says, people started thinking, oh, it was working only because Prabhupada was there. Something to that effect. How I took it from that. The lesson, you can read it. He mentions very nicely. When I was 16, I used to hold that, you know, that banner. No, I saw a lady holding the banner of Hare Krishna Mahamantra and, you know, going for an hour. And I thought, wow, this is how I was when I was, you know, like that. But abhi kya ho gaya? So then he says, realism. Then you see that things aren't as you thought it to be. So one is you come with an ideal picture. Then it crashes in front of you. And then you realize this is the reality. And then he says, what is maturity? As I understood from that thing, there are some things that will never change. What is that verse? Nasato vidyate bhavo, na bhavo vidyate satah. Ubhayorapi drishtontas tvanayos tattvadarshibhi. That tattvadarshi, a saragrahi, who understands the tattva, holds that tattva. Things may keep changing. Some things may keep changing. The way ISKCON worked earlier, sannyasis and brahmacharis were traveling all over, grahasthas were taking care of the temple. Now brahmacharis are taking, grahasthas are, situations may change, rules may change. Some things will never change. It's not that election will be held and a new supreme personality of Godhead will be chosen. Anadir adir govinda sarvakarana karanam. He is only God. In Kali Yuga, the only ways Aranam eva kevalam. These are some truths. Catch hold of those truths. And if, like I give this example, when there is a huge storm that comes, you know, wind storm, the first thing people look for is where they can run to and hold on to, which will not be blown away by the storm. If I catch hold of this harmonium during a storm, both will flow away. But if it is something that is solidly grounded, it's not going to, any storm comes, this is not going to move. If you hold on to that, close your eyes. Let the storm die down. Then you look around, whatever is available, pick it up and start your journey again. So these storms will come individually and collectively in devotees' lives. The storms are bound to come on a sensual platform, on a mental platform, on intellectual platform, so many philosophies, on the egoistic platform, tatha manapamana yoho. What is this? This is what I get for serving all these years. This is how I am treated. To hell with Hare Krishna. So these things are going to come. So as saragrahi, first know what is the sara, and only to take that sara and to hold on to that sara, and as far as possible to make our life as much as, otherwise we'll become bharavahi. Too many burden of so many ritualistic understanding and concepts. We may get caught up. We get crushed under that. Whether the authority is perfect or not, This is the way Krishna has established. Tadvidhi pranipatena pariprashtena seva. If this didn't work, I put into a plug point and if plug doesn't work, it doesn't mean that electricity, I kaam hi nahi kar, aajkal ye sab kaam nahi. We find probably this plug is not right. I need to go to find another plug where the current flows. So, we just go on with the understanding. And having faith, avashya rakshabe Krishna hita vishwas. He knows better than us exactly how to run things, when to intervene, how much to do. Okay? We do our best according to our understanding. Then leave the rest to Krishna. Does it answer your question? I just spoke my heart out.
Thank you, Guru.
Hare Krishna. Srila Prabhupada ki jai, Granthraj Srimad Bhagavatam ki jai, Nitai.